A new crew aboard the space station. Curiosity Rover's new science findings on Mars. And celebrating 60 years of NASA. A few of the stories to tell you about this week at NASA. Our astronaut Serena Anyan Chancellor arrived at the International Space Station on June 8th as part of its newest crew. Anyan Chancellor, Sergei Prokopyev of Roscosmos, and Alexander Gerst of the European Space Agency launched 2 days earlier from Kazakhstan. Meanwhile, astronaut Scott Tengel returned safely to Earth June 3rd with crewmates Norishige Kanai of Japan and Anton Shkaplerov of Russia. They spent 168 days living and working on the station. Our Curiosity rover found organic molecules preserved in Mars's harsh surface, as well as seasonal variations in the levels of methane in the Martian atmosphere that suggest the planet could have supported ancient life. Although this is not evidence of life itself, it's a good sign for future missions exploring the red planet's surface and subsurface. We kicked off our 60th birthday celebrations with concerts on June 1st and 2nd by the National Symphony Orchestra Pops at the Kennedy Center for the Performing Arts in Washington, D.C. The celebration featured performances by Will.i.am, Grace Potter, the band Coheed and Cambria, and others, as well as a poem from Star Trek actor John Cho and a new composition from Star Trek composer Michael Giacchino. An exhibit highlighted 6 decades of NASA achievements, including the Apollo moon landings envisioned by late President John F. Kennedy. Our administrator, Jim Bridenstine, discussed the agency's planned return to the moon.
We have a plan to send humans back to the moon and then onto Mars. We have the most amazing rocket designers on the planet building the systems right now that are going to take humans farther into the solar system than ever before.
Teams of students from U.S. universities participated in the second Mars Ice Challenge, June 5th through 7th. The goal is to demonstrate unique methods of extracting as much water as possible from simulated Martian subsurface ice. Future astronauts who visit distant worlds will need this kind of technology to take advantage of the resources at hand. That's what's up this week at NASA. For more on these and other stories, follow us on the web at nasa.gov/twan.